99.
Richard Rwabuhinga was yesterday elected as the chairperson of the Uganda Local Government Association in a swiftly contested election held at Kabalore District Headquarters. During his maiden speech as a new ULGA chairperson, Rwabuhinga complained about government's move to undermine decentralization.
As time went by, we have kept on witnessing the serious arm of decentralization eating up the otherwise very good policy of decentralization. This is witnessed in the attempts to use hybrid procurement for the World Bank-funded project, the latest suggestion of dissolving district service commissions. To me, this is the last nail on the decentralization policy in this country. And therefore, as ULGA, we should come up very strongly to claim what is ours. And some of these policies, as you may witness, are inconsistent with the existing laws.
The new chairperson further raised an issue of budget cuts funds allocation from the central government.
This certainly undermines service delivery in local governments and therefore the local government leadership. You cannot be a chairperson who cannot work on the road, who cannot put up a bridge, who cannot put gravel on your road. This undermines service delivery in local government and therefore local government leadership.
Also, ULGA welcomed the motion by Parliament to allow local governments to utilize the money they collect in form of taxes.
This issue is not about politics, it's about development. We want to applaud the move by Parliament to endorse it, to have monies collected by local governments left in the responsibility and allow local governments to take charge of it, to help them prioritize. That will be useful because there were systematic issues, money coming to the center, it delays to go back down, it delays service delivery. We all saw how during COVID the issue of garbage waste management in urban became an issue because they didn't have that money to appropriate immediately.
Busia District has also petitioned the Attorney General Chiriwa Chiwanuka over salary disparities.
A president can only be a person qualified to be a member of parliament, and a member of parliament is also defined. So it says three people have one qualification in the constitution, but when it comes to payment, you are paying them differently. So I am saying paying MPs amounts which are different from what is paid to district chairpersons breaks Article 441B. And this one will go through. Now you will be forced to act and pay the costs as well. Thank you.
My disappointment is that our MPs move out of power and they are pensionable, but the LC5 chairpersons move out miserable men and women.
This was the response from the State Minister of Local Government, Victoria Rusoke, who was the chief guest.
I want to stress that ULGA can be a very good force if you put it to good use. But from the contradictions I've been hearing, this side is talking something else, another side is opposing. We spent a lot of time here opposing one another, and I thought this is your 26th annual general meeting. So whatever you are to amend, you don't need war.
We are not here to argue justice. These people we are seated here, you are not there to work for Museveni. You are not there to work for ministers or MPs. You are there to promote the pride of local government.
The Iganga district chairperson raised an issue of government sending funds to districts without guidelines.
Of recent, we got a man under education without guidelines. And as we talk now, we have 344 million under Mawakala, which was left without guidelines. Policy development model, 144. I have the money without guidelines. So you need to harmonize so that you don't tempt our leaders, their administrators, to use that money for other things.
Critics say that improper absorption of government funds allocated for districts translates into poor service delivery and also slows other sectors of government.